Do you ever feel like you're wasting in a place? Do you feel like you could be more if you were somewhere else? If you have, it is a clear sign that you don't find your job fulfilling. It may be the right time to look for another job. You may start your career in a place, but there's no law that says that you must end it there. Sometimes, leaving might be just the thing you need. While most people leave jobs because of the pay to go for something better, a lot of people also leave jobs because of toxic work culture. According to Harvard Business Review, people leave their jobs because they don't like their boss, don't see opportunities for promotion or growth, or are offered a better gig and often higher pay. These reasons have held steady for years. Why do you feel tired of your own job? You may well find that your reason may not vary greatly. In today's video, I'm going to share with you 13 reasons you need to leave your job. 1. They underpay you. Naturally, any job that doesn't pay you well, no matter how great, will become a drag over time. People working in similar roles in other places may be meeting with professional colleagues in networking events and sharing remuneration information. When that happens, over time, if the remuneration is not increased to match or exceed that of other professional colleagues in the same field, the employee of the company will start to feel dissatisfied and unhappy with his or her job. This is a problem. CEOs need to learn to manage the expectations of their talents, or they will dump them for their higher-paying competitor, even if his company has more growth opportunities. Having a regular conversation with your employees is one way to mitigate this type of thing. You need to ask them what their goals and career interests are to understand how your company's work will help them get there. If you can show them that, it can motivate them to stay a while longer. Every company also needs to strategize on sales to have more income and increase salaries appropriately. Having a dedicated HR whose job is to manage their expectations and walk them through their career path can be very helpful. Any company that can afford one should have one. 2. They don't value your input. Some companies may not value your input because of their hierarchy policies. If the information has to pass through several managers to get to the person in charge, it will lead to slow decision making and also make it difficult for the business to innovate. People want to feel their work is valued. They are not just doing a meaningless routine and cashing checks. They want to know that the proposal they helped prepare helped the company close a big deal which helped a client make over $100,000 in sales. When people are given this type of feedback, it can even improve the quality of their work. Why? Because there is a clear goal. When you don't tell your employees why the email is essential and you never comment on whether they made a mistake or not, over time, it will start to feel like a routine. 3. They disrespect you. Some bosses and supervisors outrightly disrespect the employees. This is wrong. Do not yell at a grown man in front of other junior staffs because he made a typo. Send an email instead. Do not throw things at people even if they are incompetent and frustrate you. Take some time to cool off and then ring the HR to prepare a termination letter. You should not disrespect anyone simply because you employed them. People deserve respect, irrespective of who they are. The funny thing is, when you disrespect others, they in turn also disrespect you. You don't want a corporate mutiny on your hand. Just relax. Let people be. Anyone who is giving you a headache is better off working elsewhere. 4. They owe you a lot. No one enjoys being owed, not even a debtor. A business that owes its employees is more likely to lose them than one that mistreats them. This is actually pretty straightforward. People need to work to pay their bills. If people can't pay their bills, why working for you? They will simply go elsewhere where they can pay their bills. A good employee who has worked with you for over a year in which you paid consistently may forgive a month of non-payments because of the economy. They may even sympathize with you, but if this persists, they will leave. As much as they might enjoy working with you, their landlord may not extend them the same grace they have extended to you. They have to look for a way to pay them. If practicable, do not owe anyone. That way, your business reputation would not be ruined over $500. 5. They overwork you. No one likes returning home to see a work email he's expected to work on before coming to work the next day. They also do not want to be told to skip their break because the work is urgent. Are all work-related matters not urgent? People want to feel like there is a lot of work to do, but not overworked. No one will want to come in on the weekend to work and be given a mountain of work on Monday. This is something you want to be careful with. It makes logical sense to give your most efficient guy more work, but your most efficient guy may start feeling overworked, lose motivation, and burn out. You mount too much pressure on him without an equal amount of incentive and compensation. If I could do all the tasks I'm given within a month, I would get to go on a vacation, get a raise, and enjoy my break for 6 months without interruption. I will put in all my energy to achieve it because now there is something in it for me. 6. They don't offer any incentive. An employee may sometimes need an incentive to help them work harder. You need to identify which one works with who. For most people, money is great incentive. For others, it's recognition. Some people would rather get featured in Forbes than have billions of dollars to their name. They think they are successful only when they are popular. That is a flawed view. But your concern is how to get them to do their work efficiently without complaining. For the ones that like recognition, give them a target and place it side by side with the recognition and watch their productivity skyrocket. 7. They don't give you the opportunity for growth. Some organizations will only give you routine tasks and never let you out in the field where you can meet people, learn resourcefulness, and patience. By the time you leave them, all you would have learned is desk work, which makes you appear just there on your resume. 8. There is no job security. Some industries have a culture of downsizing and restructuring, which naturally puts an average employee at risk of losing their jobs. Some of these industries include investment banking and insurance. Employees who work there never really feel safe, and this can make them have a lackadaisical attitude to work because they may be let go anytime. They might as well do the job how they want. 9. They have cases of sexual harassment. Any organization with a sexual harassment case is a clear sign that such a work environment might be toxic for women to work in. If you even perceive a rumor around it, you probably shouldn't apply at all. 10. They are not empathetic. So many employers feel that employees should be grateful to them they have a job at all. This type of attitude makes them disrespect them, abuse them, and fire them at will simply because they employed them. 11. They are only interested in how much money they can make. Employers who show employees they don't care about their well-being are very likely to lose them. If someone is not at work because of illness and the HR doesn't call, it can show the person exactly what they mean to the organization. A zero among other zero working hard to produce more zeros. They may even hate your organization for it. 12. They micromanage you a lot. People don't like being micromanaged. They want to own their work. If you feel this way a lot, it might be time for you to start sending out applications. 13. They have bad supervisors. A good reason why people leave their jobs is terrible supervisors or managers. Sometimes, the manager misrepresents what the employee has said or done. When they treat the employees badly, the employees will leave.